बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। ओके स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर एबल टू लिसन टू मी। फाइन, एक्चुअली देर इज सम प्रॉब्लम विद द इंटरनेट राइट नाउ, बट एनीवे व्हाट यू नीड टू डू, इवन इफ वी डिसकनेक्ट, सो यू आर गोइंग टू रीजॉइन। ओके, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू हैव ए रिविजन for the chapter number 7 that you are going to have in your test. And you know very well that this chapter is basically about the flash tools. The test will contain all the questions, whether these are MCQs or short questions. These will be from this chapter, which is chapter number 7. Abila, you want to ask something? You have raised the hand. Yes. Yes, quickly. I am not able to listen to you loudly.
Memory bytes and sticky tops will come in our test.
Yeah, complete chapter. Complete chapter. Particularly, you will see the exercise. You will see the exercise in particular. But the test will come from anywhere from this chapter, chapter number 7. Just like we had discussed about the line tool, oval tool, rectangle tool, pen tool, how these works, what is the purpose of the eyedropper tool. Eyedropper tool is used to take the color. If you want to choose a color, if you want to copy a color, then eyedropper tool will be used. Okay. Similarly, we had discussed about the primitive rectangle tool, primitive oval tool. These are the options which are available in drawing shapes. How we can import one image inside the flash? I had explained you this thing as well. How we can change the image size according to the stage size. How we can transform objects. One tool is there with the name of transform tool, using which you can resize the images. You can change the sizes of the images. You can apply some different option on the images. So the MCQs will be regarding these tools and their uses, and you know, the differences between two tools. For example, what is the difference between selection tool and transform tool? Of course, selection tool is used to select one object, and transform tool is basically a tool which is used to change the size, length or breadth of the object, or to make some change in the shape of the object. So these all things we had discussed about, and these things are there about which we did the practice as well. We applied the lab activities as well for this chapter. To move the selected object, position the pointer over the selected object so that the pointer changes to a cross. Drag the object to a new position. Normally, the questions about these steps will not be asked in the paper. The paper will contain the questions like which are related to the use of a particular tool, use of a particular type of object, use of particular command, just like we had studied how to hide the ruler, how to hide the toolbox, how to bring the toolbox. All these commands are available in your flash if you go to the flash. So these commands in the text of the book, some commands are also given, but you know that whenever any shortcut is asked, you should always see that these shortcuts are given over here in these menus. For example, to open the file, Control O. To take new file, Control N. Okay, to close, Control W. To save, Control S. To save as, Control Shift S. So these are the shortcuts which are given in these menus. We can go to these menus and we can find out what is the shortcut for any purpose. For example, if I say that what is the shortcut to show and hide the ruler, you are going to say rulers. You are going to say Control Alt Shift R. What is the shortcut to show the properties? Control F3. Okay, what is the shortcut to show the tools, toolbox, Control 2. For example, if I say this is the toolbox, then Control 2. Although these all are not included in this chapter, but I am saying that those things which are there in this chapter, in the text of this chapter, you should consider at least these things. How we can rotate the object? We can rotate the object using transform tool. We had applied this thing that whenever we have got any object, just like rectangle, triangle, polygon, and we select, we click on the transform tool, then we can apply the rotation as well. We can change its direction. So how rotation can be applied using which tool? Let's suppose if it is asked in your MCQs. So you are going to say that transformation will be applied using the rotation will be applied using transform tool. Scaling an object means resizing an object. Scaling means resizing. Whether you are resizing the length or you are resizing the breadth, or you are resizing length and breadth equivalently with the equal proportion by pressing shift, I had explained you this thing as well. Gradient transform is basically related to the colors. Gradient means colors. When we are concerned with the colors, then we apply the gradient. Basically, if you go to the flash, you will see that this is the gradient is available over here with the transform tool. This is the gradient. Let's suppose, just like, let me give you an example. This is a rectangle that I have drawn. If I click on the transform tool, I can rotate it in this way. I can make rotation. Okay. Let's suppose I take another rectangle without any border in green color. So transform tool, basically the transform tool is used to change the direction of the direction of the object that we have drawn. Okay. Similarly, when we click the transform tool, we can change the size of the object. This thing we know very well. Now, what is the use of the gradient tool? If you go to the gradient tool, gradient is basically filling the color. Now, what I have selected, gradient fill. This is the tool, gradient transform tool. Now what I am going to take, I am going to take some fill color from here and I am going to drop over here. I take this color. And I take this transform tool. Using this bucket, basically this is the parent bucket which is used to fill. Now when I have dropped, so it is giving you multiple colors with it. Can you see this? If I drop top to bottom, you can see these multiple colors in this direction. If I drop it diagonally, you can see these colors in this direction. If I drop it in this direction, so basically this is the option that we can apply using gradient transform tool. Basically what we are going to do, we are going to apply some color. and the color that we are applying is basically multiple color that we have taken. We can even change these colors as well. For example, red, then this pink, dark pink, then blue. Then if you want to change them, then you can, for example, instead of red, I want to take here yellow. Okay, let's suppose I want to have yellow color over here in the first one. In the first one, I want to have yellow color, for example. In second one, I want to have blue color, let's suppose. In third one, I want to have, let's suppose, I'm just giving the example, red color. In fourth one, I want to have any other color you can take. Then I want to have again yellow color or green color or purple color. Then you are going to drop it. When you will drop it, you will see that you will find these color schemes. Can you see this? Just like whatever we have selected the colors from here. So this basically, this is the purpose of the gradient. And we can fill the gradient in linear way, and we can fill the gradient in circular way as well. Circular is also there. Circular means which is basically radial gradient. Radial and linear, these are the two options. What I have explained you, this is basically the color which is basically the transform color in, you know, in linear way. So if you go there, you can find out that we can also apply these things to let's suppose I take this color. So radial color is also there. Radial means when we are applying these multiple colors from the center, and these are basically in a round shape. When you select the gradient transform tool and click on the object filled with a radial gradient, it looks as shown in the adjacent figure. Notice the ellipse around the object. This is basically the ellipse round shape. As in the case of linear gradient, you can drag the center point to the adjust the center of the gradient. You can also drag the adjustment handles to change the size of radius or radius of the gradient. So basically, what can be asked in your paper? What are the two different ways? What are the two different ways to use the transform gradient transform tool? You are going to say basically gradient transform tool is used for linear gradient, just like the colors are there in a horizontal manner. Multiple colors are there in the horizontal manner. Similarly, we have got this tool as well. When we have got this option, the radial gradient, when the colors are basically dropped in a rounded shape. So in these two ways, we can have the two types of the fill colors. And this is the tool that you are going to apply in your flash. How we can change the colors? As I have explained you, we can change the colors from here. This is the option from the color palette. The color palette is given over here. You know that if the color palette is off, then we can switch it on from the Windows. Shift F9 is the shortcut to switch on the color palette. From here, we can change the color. Okay, whatever color is there that we want to apply, so we can change this color as well. These colors, as I have told you, these are the buttons using which we can apply the changes. We can apply changes to these colors, and we can make some different type of, you know, combination with it. So basically, this is the purpose of the tool. You can see over here how much we can change the gradient fill as well. We can apply changes to the gradient fill option as well in different manners. Just like you can see over here. Now, if you go to the next topic, but before going to the next topic, let me mark the attendance. Yes, Musfira.
Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Wa alaikum salam. Yes.
Sir, can you explain gradient rule again?
Okay, just a minute. Okay, fine. Let me mark the attendance first. So we have got Abila, Ali, to Mayra, Maria, and then Samia Sajjan. Gradient tool is basically the tool which is used to fill any object. Just like if we draw some rectangle over here, just take this example. Right now, this is already filled with this color. Otherwise, if you draw a rectangle in this way, just like it is in brown color. But if I go to the gradient transform tool, if I select this and I take some multicolor option from here, and I take paint bucket tool and I drop on it. So in any direction I can drop it, just like from left to right, from right to left, from top to bottom in this way, from bottom to top, diagonally, wherever, in any direction. If you want to apply it, you can apply it. You can change these colors from here, from the color palette option. Multiple colors are there. You can make different changes in these colors according to your requirement, and then you can apply these colors to over here. So basically, this is the gradient fill option that you can apply over here. We can fill it with a plain color as well, depending on our requirement. Okay, now come to the next point. How we can change the shapes using arrow tool. Arrow tool is very important, selection tool or the arrow tool. This is the thing that I had explained you, that if you have got some, for example, this is a rectangle, I want to change its shape. How can I change its shape? I can bring my mouse cursor on the corner, and if I want to change the shape, let's suppose I can change its shape. I bring the mouse cursor on the corner, it is converted to basically a angle, then I can change its shape. If I bring to the line, then it is converted to an arc. So in this way, we can apply different changes to different kind of shapes to make different kind of things. If you want to create a corner, you will press Control and you can create corners anywhere. For example, there isn't any corner over here. I can create one corner over here. So in this way, we can, you know, convert any object to anything. Basically, any other object can be converted to any other object. One object can be converted to any other object. So this is basically the phenomena that we can apply by arrow tool. Means selection tool is also very much important, having very much options with it. When we bring it to the corner, it can change it. Or when we bring to the side, we can make it round. If we are not applying with the control, and if we are applying with the control, then we can create another corner over here. If we press control button, we can create a copy of it, just like. So a number of options are there with this selection tool. Just like I have created one copy of the object. How we can create the copy? By pressing the control button. If I take it over here and I press control and then I release, I can create multiple copies okay, in this way. So selection tool is very important, and now we can change it. If you remember, we had converted one polystar by taking the polystar from here. But it is polygon, so I am going to take one polystar. Let me change it to polystar. If you remember, we had converted one star into flower shape. How? By changing the shape of the petals, shape of the corners of the stars in the form of petals. If you remember, we had done it and we had created some flowers using this technique. So in this way you can do it. Anyway, we move ahead. Okay, then property inspector is there, from where we can change the properties. What is the thing in the properties? Basically, it depends on the tool that we have selected and the object we have drawn. Just like right now, if I have drawn one polygon, the properties will be related to the polygon, just like multiple sides are there. Color is there, outline is there, outline thickness is there. So we can apply these all things. When we have selected, let's suppose, oval tool, then when we draw an oval shape, its properties will be according to this tool, this oval tool. So you can see over here, when we take the properties of the oval shape, then the properties are basically according to this shape. The properties will be changed when we take any object. So according to that particular object, the properties will be changed. So you need to go through the properties. When you have taken rectangle, what properties are there? When we have taken primitive rectangle, what properties? Some more properties are there in the primitive rectangle tool. Okay. So you have to go through this complete chapter. Grouping outlines and fills, we can combine different objects with each other. How to type the text, how to change its color. This is the phenomena that we have applied, converting the shapes into basic shapes. If you remember, we had applied that if you type the text, if you type some text, for example, if I type over here, then this text that I have typed, it is basically a text, but I can convert it to some shape. Right click on it, convert, break it apart. Again, right click on it and break it apart. Then you will see that there are now this M, P and S are basic drawings. I can change its shape even. Why? Because now this is not a text. This is basically not a text now. That's why I can change its shape. Getting this thing? So you have to go through this, complete chapter, and you will be able to see that what is the purpose of the timeline. The timeline deals with the sequence of the objects, how these are placed on this stage, how these are going to move on this stage. So these all are the very important things. What is the procedure to do the shape twin, and what is the procedure to apply the twin motion? We had gone through both the things, shape twin as well as twin motion. In twin motion, object only moves from one place to another place. And what happens in the shape twin, object not only moves, but also changes its shape. For example, circle is being shaped to star, or star is being converted to circle when it is moving from left side to right side. On left side, it was a star, but when on right side, when it reached, it is converted to the circle or rectangle or polygon or something like that. So in the previous videos, the procedure is there. Definitely the procedure is not going to be asked. It's not going to be asked that write down the procedure, how you are going to create shape twin. No, what is shape twin? This kind of question can be asked. What do you understand by the twin motion? Similarly, the questions which are given at the end of this chapter are also very important. You will have to go through it, and I have given the question and answers for that chapter as well, so you can go through it. Now our class time is now over. Kindly prepare yourself for your exams. So inshallah tomorrow, I think in the fourth unit you are going to have your test. Can anyone raise the hand and let me confirm? In which unit you are aware of the test timing? For computer science? Yes, Masfira. Tomorrow in fourth unit?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Fine, fine. Okay, thank you so much, all of you. Please prepare yourself and try to get good marks.